Umuwas ng galit ng publiko matapos pumatok ang balita na sangkot umano si Pangulong Cotting Jr. sa pagkawala ng 90 milyong piso na pondo ng PhilHealth. Ayon sa mga ulat lumabas sa isang masusing investigasyon na may kinalaman ng mataas na opisyal sa anomalya dahilan para mag-alboroto ang taong bayan at maglunsad ng mga protesta sa iba't ibang panig ng bansa. Sa isang payag, maringin itinanggi ni Cotting Jr. ang mga paratang at giniit na wala siyang kinalaman sa mga irregularidad sa ahensya. Gayunpaman, patuloy na lumalaki ang galit ng publiko dahil sa kawalan ng malinaw na paliwanag ukol sa nawawalang pondo. Maraming sektor ang nananawag ng agarang aksyon mula sa pambalaan upang mapanagot ang mga responsable sa anomalya.
Lalo na't apektado nito ang kalusugan ng mga Pilipino sa gitna ng pandemya at iba pang suliring pangkalusugan. Nagbayag naman ng suportang ilang mambabatas para sa imbisigasyon at hinihikayat ang mas masusing pagsisiyasat upang matukoy ang tunay na ugat ng pagkawala ng pondo. Samantala, patuloy ang mga kilos protesta sa mga pangunahing lungsod ng bansa. Patuloy naman ang pagkilos rin sa habang inaabaga ng publiko ang mga susunod na hakbang ng pabalaan para maibalik ang tiwala ng sambayanan sa PhilHealth. Well, ito nga ang balitang ating pagkakatutukan. Ngunit bagong lahat, siguraduhin mag-subscribe at i-hit ang notification bell para tuloy-tuloy ang pagtutok mo sa mga bago at nagbabagang balita dito sa Bangon Pinas.
A directive, no, which emanated from a cabinet meeting led by President Marcos, asking me to remit the 89.9 billion. So like a good soldier, I am following them, no.
Unacceptable po itong pag-transfer. Well, marami pang naghihingalo ng mga kababayan natin, walang pambayad sa hospital.
But Senator, I am just an ordinary member of this government. I was asked to do something. Thank you, Honorable Mr. Chair, Senator Bongo. Good morning, and rest assured, Senator Go, all that you mentioned earlier is taken into consideration at PhilHealth. And we just want to mention again that, Senator, every time you call a hearing in aid of legislation, kahit weekend po, kahit may bagyo po, PhilHealth is always in perfect attendance po. So we're fully supportive of all that you do for the health sector. Also, Senator, we hear your 5 points that you want PhilHealth to tackle, and I'm sure that will all be brought up during the hearing. But I just want to mention before the hearing starts that around a week ago, Senator, we were in Congress. PhilHealth was in Congress with DOH for the budget hearing, no, appropriations, and we were there for 14 hours straight. And it was during that hearing that I had mentioned to the chair, Kong Stella and Kong Garin, no, that we are currently reviewing in PhilHealth, no, we are currently reviewing up to a 50% increase on all case rates almost across the board, and we feel we can submit that before the year ends, no. In line with that, Senator, nung sinabi ko yan, sabi po ni ng committee ng hearing, sabi na masyadong matagal yung year end. So pinapaspasan po namin, hopefully maybe within 1 to 2 months po, marerecommend na namin po yan, no, and maybe eventually shortly thereafter implement it, no. Now in line with that, Senator Go, so we were considering a 50% increase of case rates almost across the board. Maganda po yung sinuggest ni Kong Stella Kimbo. Sabi niya kasi masyadong inflationary po yon. Although we do full rationalization, no. Dahil sinuggest ni Kong Stella masyadong inflationary yon, what we decided to do, Senator Go, instead of recommending a almost across the board 50% increase, what we will do is we will focus on the top 10 most common diseases in terms of mortality and morbidity, and we will focus on increasing those top 10. Kahit iba-iba, hindi.
Sa ngayon, 30% ang in-increase nyo?
Sa ngayon po, last February 14, we increased by 30% almost across the board.
Pwede mong ma-explain itong case rate? Kasi ang taas tingnan eh, 30%. Tapos before the year ends, sasabihin nyo 60%. Pwede nyo bang maklaro sa publiko kung yung computation niya? Kasi parang sa tingin ko, napakababa pa rin eh.
Yes po.
Mamaya, 1,000 lang yung sa i-cover ng... sa 300,000 in-increase nyo, baka 1,000 lang, tapos in-increase nyo ulit ng 30%, 2,000 lang.
Actually, okay,
pwede nyo explain na mabuti. Magbigay kayo ng example.
Yes, sir. Actually, sir, if we're given the chance during the hearing, we'll papa-explain namin po very in details para maintindihan po ng Honorable Committee. So going back to that, Senator, so we committed that, no? We committed that to the House Committee, no? And instead of the 50% increase almost across the board, we will look at increasing the top 10 most common diseases, no, based on mortality and morbidity. And just for the information of this Honorable Committee, those top 10 diseases comprise almost 80% of the total case rates. So halos ganun na rin yan po, kasi almost covered na rin yan eh. So it will come out almost across the board na rin po, no. Secondly, sir, on your Honorable Chair, on your other issues, no, we're prepared to address it later, no, in detail, yung single period of confinement, and then yung payment of claims to hospitals, no. Very briefly, on the 15 billion yung utang po namin sa DOH, no, na sinasabi ninyo po at sinasabi ni Sec. Herbosa, no. Again, we are currently doing reconciliation on those, no. And I'm confident after the reconciliation po, yung 15 billion na yan, siguro magiging mga 3 to 4 billion na lang yan. So yan yung talagang totoo, diba? So pag madinig nyo or magbasa kayo na 15 billion ang utang ng Philippines, hindi po totoo yun, diba? Dahil marami dyan, RTH, marami dyan denied, diba? So I keep on reiterating sana, I keep on asking Honorable Secretary Herbosa, no? Sana wag ka muna magsabi sa media na mga ganun. Kasi yung statements na yun, pag pinipick up, ibang nakukuha ng mga tao, eh, diba? So I've asked him a couple of times, although it seems like, I mean, he really feels maybe he wants to get paid, no? So we're doing reconciliation immediately po, and we will...
Ito yung sa mga government hospitals?
Yes po, yung 14.8 billion na minute.
Wala lang sa private hospitals dito?
Wala po.
So wala na kayong...
Excluded po ang private hospitals po.
I mean, wala na kayong payable sa private hospitals? Wala na kayong reklamo sa ngayon?
Senator. Actually, they're all very, very happy with the improvements in the payments of claims on the private side.
So wala nang mga reklamong payable sa kanila?
Actually, wala nang mga reklamo. In fact, ang maraming ang nakukuha namin, hindi reklamo, puro commendations at saka...
Alam mo na, importante rin yun, aside from government hospitals, itong mga private hospitals. Kasi kailangan rin nilang mag-roll, no? Paikutin yung operational expenses rin nila, operational funds nila.
Yes.
Wala naman silang pang sweldo sa mga medical workers kung wala silang pondo. So dapat hindi matagalan yung kanilang claims. Not only sa mga government hospitals, including private hospitals din. Tingnan niyo rin po ng mabuti. Since andyan dyan naman po ang pondo ng PhilHealth.
Yes po.
Buti sana kung nangutang kayo, wala kayong pambayad, andyan yung pondo eh.
Yes,
sobra-sobra yung pondo ninyo. Eh kung valid naman yung claims, huwag niyo nang patagalin. Kailangan rin nilang umikot rin po ang kanilang panggasto sa hospital.
Yes po. Po, on the point of the reduction of the premium contribution, which I promised you and you aired earlier, I looked at the Senate amendment that you are passing po. I think you're an author of that bill, no? Maganda po yun. I'd like to reiterate that we are fully supportive of that reduction in premium contribution. And what we will need to do, Senator, is we will have to bring that up to the board of directors in PhilHealth, no? And I'm not so sure that everyone is supportive. Basta ako personally, as a vice chair and as president, I'm fully supportive. But I will have to discuss
aside it. Aside from... sa batas na ito na amending the universal healthcare to reducing the premium contribution from 5% to 3.25% sa 2025 bill pa ito, no, pumasa na
yes.
Ito sa Senado,
yes po.
At sana'y magiging batas ko ito, pero pwera dyan, before we pass it, nangako ka noon, sabi mo you will recommend to the president, no, na i-reduce po yung premium contribution. Kumusta na po inyong recommendation sa presidente?
Actually, we've been doing studies po now. We've came out with very similar to the Senate amendment. So what I was planning to do is I would just put it together then recommend it to the board of directors. Because I cannot go naman directly to the president eh. Kailangan kumuha muna ng approval sa board of directors. So I'll have to see if the board will go along with it, no? Clearly, if the board doesn't go along with it, wala akong magagawa. My hands are tied, Senator. No. So that's yan ang plano ko sana. Kasi maganda na yung ano eh, very very similar siya sa Senate amendment, magandang reduction eh. Maganda yung suggestion dun eh.
So ibig sabihin, pabor ka rito sa may pasa itong batas na to, reduce it.
Oh, definitely. 110% po.
May pakiusap lang ako sa iyo, President Ledesma. Sa magiging decision mo, parati, isipin mo lang parati yung mga mahirap nating kababayan, yung mga pasyente. Yun lang parati mong isipin. Hindi ka magkakamali doon. Isaalang-alang mo parati yung kapakanan ng mga mahirap na pasyente na walang pambayad po. Yun lang po ang parati mong isipin, yung mga mahirap na ating kababayan. Hindi ka magkakamali dyan.
Thank you for that, Senator. Then, Senator, one more thing before I read my very brief opening statement. No? Again, with regards to the 89.9 billion, because, you know, it's not only you, Honorable Senator, it's not only Honorable Rafi Tulfo. Everyone is texting me, calling me, saying, ba't hindi mo inisip yung health concerns ng mga tao, pera ng health yan, bakit mo ginagawa yan? Again, I want to reiterate to this Honorable Committee and to everyone here in this room, no? I received a directive, no, which emanated from a cabinet meeting led by President Marcos, asking me to remit the 89.9 billion. So like a good soldier, I am following them, no. Now, I'm not a lawyer po. So of course, before I did it, I made sure I got clearance from COA, from GCG, and from OGCC. And today, I'm very happy to see my good friend here with us because yesterday, I don't know if you're aware, Sol Jen came out with a lot of opinions, very good opinions and statements, no, regarding this transfer that it is legal, it is above board, blah blah blah, blah and all that, no. So,
you mean legally, possible po ito?
Yes po.
So legally possible yung
transfer. Again po, I'm not a lawyer, but that's my understanding based on the opinions of COA, GCG, OGCC, and as of yesterday, Sol Jen.
So legally lusot kayo, but for me morally, unacceptable po itong pag-transfer. Marami pang naghihingalo ng mga kababayan natin. Walang pambayad sa hospital.
But, Senator, I am just an ordinary member of this government. I was asked to do something. How can I go against it,
sir? Sa lahat ng magiging decision mo, isipin mo parate yung mga mahirap, yung mga pasyenteng naghihingalo na walang pambayad. Isipin mo lang parate yun. Isipin mo lang parate. Parate mong isipin yun sa magiging decision mo pa. Sa mga susunod pang mga policies na inyong isusulong, na i-amend, na ayusin, isipin mo yung pasyente. Please, yun lang ang isipin.
Yes, Senator. Yes, we'll do, Senator.
You may not like the person. You may not like the presence here, but you have to respect the office of the Vice President.
Madam Chair, please.
So, Madam Chair,
before you proceed, I'd like to remind our members for orderly proceedings, please wait to be acknowledged speak. So, sa ngayon po, dahil nauna po si Kong France, paunahin na muna natin siya. So, Kong France, please proceed. And then I will recognize you after.
Kakasunod, Madam.
Medyo nauna lang po siya ng 1-7 po.
Di ba ang ating tradisyon, unang minority, pagkatas majority?
Wala pa po tayo sa interpretation, Kong Dante.
Po, pero maski na sa manifestation, dapat ganun din.
Nauna lang po siya, so, yes po. Kong France, please proceed.
Thank you, Madam Chair. So, ang ibig sabihin nito ay kahit na binigyan natin ang Office of the Vice President na second time around na magpaliwanag do sa budget at magkaroon tayo ng pagkakataon na siya ay matanong dahil ito naman po talaga yung mandato natin dito sa Kongreso, no, mabusisi yung budget. So ang ibig sabihin po nito ay binoboycott niya tayo. Pagboboycott ito, Madam Chair, dahil wala pang akong natatandaan na ahensya ng gobyerno o executive branch na binoycott ang Kongreso dito sa budget hearing and deliberation. So ang ibig sabihin, Madam Chair, betrayal of her oath of office. Kahapon nakita ko yung kanyang video na ginagalang niya yung power of the purse ng Kongreso. Alam niya na tayo po yung nag-allocate or nagba-budget or nagpa-approve ng budget ng lahat ng ahensya. So dahil pinapaubayan niya na sa atin ito, na hindi niya man lang i-defend, kasi laki-laki nung Madam Chair, yung budget for socio-economic program delivery, socio-economic projects and stakeholder. Ang ibig sabihin ba niyan, inaabandon na niya na yung pinaplano niya siguro na ng mga constituents niya na bibigyan niya nitong mga programs na ito. So Madam Chair, so ang problema dito, no, talagang Bratenella to the max, no? Na ayaw nang matanong, no? Umiiwas sa mga tanong. At eto pa, no, kapag gusto nating tanungin, hindi umaattend doon sa . Kaya talagang Madam Chair, siguro later on, kung ano yung later on na lang po, Madam Chair, yung aking magiging pasya, no, dito sa magiging budget at recommendation sa budget ng OBP. So, pasensya na po, ang taong bayan, binoycott tayo ng Vice President.
Salamat, Kong France. Kong Margolera, you're now recognized.
Salamat po, Madam Chair. Yung hindi po pagdating ng ating pangalawang pangulo ngayon, Ang suspecha ko po ay dahil sa nangyari ng mga pagtatanong nung nakaraang pagdinig. I have heard the volume and the barrage of questions asked by members of this committee to the Vice President. Despite the fact, Madam Chair, I heard her several times saying, I forgo the opportunity of defending the OBP budget for 2025 by question and answer, and I leave it to the House of Representatives to decide on such proposal as presented. That was the template of an answer given by the Office of the Vice President. Madam Chair, napilitan po akong mag-raise ng parliamentary inquiry. I think I have earned this. If I survive my term up to next year, I would have survived also, or I would have completed 18 years in this institution. And in this length of time, I have observed a tradition. The tradition is the two highest positions of government, namely the office of the Vice President and the office of the President, are not traditionally subjected to questions. I have observed this for so long a time. May I refresh the memory of the members of this committee, Madam Chair? In 2022, the minority leader, Honorable Libanan, citing courtesy to the office of the Vice President, took only about 13 minutes to move for the termination of the budget of the Vice President. And after that, the majority leader seconded the motion. That was 2022, Madam Chair. Then 2023, no less than the presidential son, our own senior deputy majority leader, the Honorable Sandro Marcos, stood up and invoked the long-honored tradition of according courtesy to the OBP, the office of the Vice President. And in the same manner, he moved for the termination of the office of the budget, the consideration of the budget of the office of the President, Vice President. I also recall, Madam Chair, that it was terminated. And with the full consternation of Honorable Franz Castro, who then objected, but her objections were never heard until she moved to make up record by way of manifestation her objection. But the committee collectively said, you can no longer do that because there was already a termination of the hearing. This is the time-honored tradition, Madam Chair. For so long a time, we have kept and observed this. We have upheld this tradition. My question is this committee authorized to set aside or discard the tradition? That is the question.
Your Honor, such motion was not introduced in the last hearing.
I'm now introducing the motion, Madam Chair.
I second, Madam Chair.
To terminate the consideration of the budget of the Vice President, Madam Chair, on the basis of the long and time-honored tradition, Madam Chair, in order for us to respect a tradition in the same manner that we have respected the tradition here, that the first to interpolate every time is the member of the minority. That is the tradition. We have not yet discarded that. We're observing that because we are honorable members of this Congress. So the question is, why have we discarded that tradition? Is this committee authorized to set aside the tradition? If we are not able to do that, Madam Chair, then I honorably, respectfully now move to terminate consideration of the budget of the office of the Vice President, and I so move.
Second, Madam Chair.
Thank you.
Madam Chair.
Bakit nangyari po nung nakarap, nangyayari?
Move and seconded.
Session suspended.
You may not like the person. You may not like the presence here, but you have to respect the office of the Vice President. That is all. Because that is guided by the tradition. Kahapon po, nagaya po na sinabi nila, wala nang pinagtanong sa office of the President. And that is correct. That is in line with that tradition. Ngayon po, kung ang tinatanong ko ngayon, are we discarding the tradition? And is this committee authorized to discard the well-kept tradition? O kaya na, then why are we intending to ask questions na naman at pinatawag nyo na naman kung sino-sino dito. That is why, kung hindi po kayo makakasagot, madam, ang tinanong ko na sa inyo, I am now moving. Liberty na yun na ba?
We will take that up after we respond to the Honorable Margoleta.
Thank you, Madam
Chair. Yes, we note that you made an objection, but your mic was off. So, the Honorable Margoleta, please repeat your inquiry.
Yes, in connection to the earlier parliamentary inquiry, Madam Chair, I have already related the value of tradition. Parliamentary procedures, Madam Chair, grow from or are enriched by traditions, experiences, and precedents collectively gathered by the House of Representatives over years, and the institution keeps them well. That is why, from my entry in 2004 or the 13th Congress until today, I have observed the observance of that well-kept tradition. The two highest positions in government, namely the Office of the President and the Office of the Vice President, were duly accorded with respect and deference. I have observed that. That's why I have relayed to you earlier, in 2022, the Honorable Libanan, invoking courtesy, took him only 13 minutes to dispose the office of the Vice President. And that was quickly moved, quickly seconded by no less than our majority leader. That was in 2022. I'm not going by record, Madam Chair. 2023, I said, no less than the presidential son, our own senior deputy majority leader, stood up and said that in line with the time-honored tradition of according courtesy to the office of the Vice President, I move to terminate the budget briefing of the OBP. And I can recall the Honorable Castro strongly objected.
No, Manuel.
No, that's in 2023. This is by the record. And she objected, but her objections were rejected by the committee because the committee already terminated the proceedings. And she kept on requesting, Madam Chair, that she makes at least a manifestation. And she was unable to do that because the proceedings were terminated. So that what I am saying, from 2004, when I entered these halls, these hallowed halls, hanggang punto sa sinasabi kong 2023, we have kept the tradition. Ngayon po, kung ano-ano ng mga tanong ang ginawa, in 2022, 22 minutes. 2022, 13 minutes. Ito po, pinagawa yan na po yung budget earlier at ngayon, we're about to quarrel again on the budget. Ang tanong ko nga po ngayon, dahil nga po sa nangyayari ngayon sa budget ng Office of the Vice President, and despite her manifestation that she will no longer defend her budget because sabi niya, I will forgo my opportunity to defend the budget of the OBP for 2025 by way of question and answer, and I will leave to the House of Representatives to decide such proposal as presented. We cannot even accept such kind of answer, Madam Chair. What do we need her to articulate for? So ang pinag-uusapan po natin, wala na po ba yung respeto sa tradisyon na yun? Kagaya po ng binabanggit ko, every time mag-i-interpellate po dito, Madam Chair, because of that tradition, it's always the member of the minority who will start the interpellation because we have kept that tradition. Ang dami po. Ang dami ko pang sasabihin sa inyo, mahaba lang tayo. So the question is, when we did that to the Vice President earlier, now we're doing it now, are we now setting aside this tradition? That's the number one question. Number two, is this committee authorized to set aside the tradition?
Your Honor, short answer is no to both questions.
Okay. If that is the answer, Madam Chair, and we are all bound to respect one tradition so sacred in our hearts because we are called honorables in this house. We cannot be honorables if we cannot honor our own tradition. We are defined by what we believe as a tradition in this house. So if we are now all amenable that we have kept that tradition, no longer questions are being asked, then I will respectfully move, Madam Chair, to move to terminate the budget of the OBP for 2025.
I object, Madam Chair.
Thank you.
I object.
Madam Chair,
there's a motion to terminate the budget briefing of the OVP, but there is an objection, so we divide the House. The Chair has decided to divide the House. So those in favor of the motion,
as a rule, we usually deliberate before we
vote. Those in favor of the motion, please raise your hand. Those in favor of the motion to terminate the budget briefing of the OVP, please raise your hand. Those who are not in favor of terminating, raise your hand.
We're not petition.
Three in favor, 45 against. The motion is
lost.
Madam Chair, I thought we have kept the tradition. The tradition is no longer ask any question. That was the tradition. So why are you voting against the motion?
The majority of the win is always respected.
It's inconsistent with the tradition that we have already agreed to observe.
So, we will
yes, Madam Chair. You mentioned earlier that we will keep up the tradition. You said no. Earlier,
for
no.
We proceedings, voted I remind the members to please wait to be recognized before speaking. So, the Chair now recognizes the budget sponsor, the Honorable Zia Adyong, to give a recap of what transpired in the last hearing.
Madam Chair.
Thank you, Madam Chair.
Okay, before we proceed with Vice Chair Adyong, can I explain my vote, Ms. Madam Chair?
Paduano?
Can I explain my vote? Why I voted against the motion of the Honorable Marcoleta? Just short lang.
You have 1 minute.
Thank you po. Madam Chair, tama po. During the previous hearing, wala pong nag-move to terminate the budget. That's number one po of the OBP. Number two po, the demeanor of the answers being given by the Vice President during the time. Personally, it does not satisfy this representation. Thirdly, Madam Chair, the courtesy being given to the Office of the Vice President is afforded if she's present in today's hearing. How can you give that courtesy when Paki is absent in today's hearing, Madam Chair? I might change my vote for that, but...
Was the President of the Philippines present?
Please wait to be recognized,
Madam Chair.
Please wait to be recognized. Please proceed, Kong Paduano.
You're not yet recognized, Marcoleta. Madam Chair, maybe I will change my vote if the
Wow, nakakaloka ha. Eh, bakit si PBBM ay hindi nga dumalo dyan ngayon? Bakit nyo inaprubahan kaagad yung budget niya? Wala pa nga 15 minutes. Aprobado na kaagad.
Sus, kalami ninyo laparuhog durian eh.
That courtesy should be given to those head of office that should be present during the budget deliberation, Madam Chairman. Thank you.
Madam Chair.
What is your point of order? And please explain the rule that is violated.
The rule violated, Madam Chair, is our tradition. You just upheld that the tradition will be respected. And so if questions will still be asked, then the tradition that we have kept so well, that you have said that we're not about to discard right now, will be disrespected again. I thought we understood each other.
There was already a ruling.
Kong Marcoleta.
Sa mga pangyayaring iyong araw, ang pag-uulat nito ay nagtatapos na. Naway nagbigay ito ng karagdagang kaalaman at pag-unawa sa mga pangyayari sa ating lipunan. Patuloy tayong maging bahagi at mapanuri sa mga susunod na kaganapan. Maraming salamat sa inyong pagkikinig at pagtangkilik sa aming balita. Hanggang sa susunod na pagkakataon, ito ang Bangon Pinas, nagbabalita para sa inyo.